Well, great. Guys, I am here with Alina Wilson today, who is just one of 19 certified Xactimate trainers in the nation. And she is the mastermind and creator behind Xactimate Mastery for storm restoration contractors. Basically, Alina teaches storm restoration contractors how to master Xactimate to not just be proficient at like the basic survival skills, but to maximize insurance supplements, perfect retail estimates, and really just use the software to your advantage during adjuster negotiations. Basically, how to squeeze every ounce of value out of the software above and beyond just writing simple estimates. So, Alina, fire away. What is this program about in your words?
Yeah, so basically this is a comprehensive online course that simplifies mastering Xactimate for specifically for storm restoration contractors who use the software to do insurance claims. So I'm teaching all the shortcuts and Xactimate hacks that cut estimating time in half, step-by-step how to create better supplements, and some more advanced features like using sketching and macros. And it's all organized in one place.
Right.
One of the most crucial components of the estimating supplementing success lies in truly mastering Xactimate above and beyond simply being able to draft an estimate. 96% of carriers use it, so these guys need to be pros at using it. And it can either be their biggest weakness or it could be their strongest strength when it comes to negotiating scope and price for claims.
Right. Yeah, absolutely. I would say that the average contractor can self-teach himself the software to be proficient at putting together like a basic estimate. But the key components that really take estimating and supplementing success to like that expert level where you make the software work for you, like above and beyond just being a regular tool, like that stuff is way over most people's heads. They just have no idea. Plus, if you're a business owner running a company and you're trying to teach like your staff or your salesman how to use the software, even though it's one of the most important aspects of the claims process they should learn, it's like you are running a company wearing 5,000 hats. Your time is not best spent trying to teach these guys personally how to use a software that you don't even 100% know how to use, right? So like having it all set up as a comprehensive online course that teaches everything you need to know and nothing you don't for storm restoration specifically is clutch, you know? Like you can literally take your guys, stick them in front of the computer, hit play and say, watch these videos. And they're taught in a few hours and they can go back to it anytime they have a question over and over and over again for the rest of your life. You never have to teach anybody how to do it again, you know?
So. Exactly. Yep. That's exactly the point here. You know, there's countless options for insurance adjusters to learn this, but there are little to no resources available for, you know, storm restoration contractors to learn the insides in and outs of the software. It's just the way it is. It's just the world we live in. So that's why I built this program, because there's this huge knowledge gap in the industry.
Yeah, I agree. Well, let's go ahead and let's take a virtual tour. How about, and we'll just kind of show everybody like exactly what's inside the program so they know what they're getting.
Yeah, sounds good. Let's take a look. So this is what the membership site looks like, and let's just walk through some of the content here to see what I've created and some of the topics that I cover in the course.
Right.
So this is the homepage here, and what you can do is just hover over these sidebars here, and we'll get to be able to look at what the content is. So we've got the very basics. I mean, like, you've never opened the software before, so you can sit a person down that's never even seen Xactimate. That's where this starts. So that's where they begin to master Xactimate.
Right.
All of these topics in this section are geared towards the basic beginner. However, even seasoned users are going to get something out of the topics in there, because I'm showing a little glimmer of what the program can do. So I don't want to shy away anybody who thinks that they, you know, they're seasoned. There is some other good information for those that have used the program before too, as well.
Well, and it goes back to, even though you have like this first lesson, for example, the first section is basic stuff, that might not necessarily be something that, for example, I would need to know, except for the bits and pieces you're telling me that I'd surprisingly learn. But if I'm a business owner and I have four sales guys that are supposed to be writing estimates, or even one person, I don't have to take this time to teach them what I know based on what I think I know from the last version I used, right?
Right. So, yeah, exactly.
So what are the lessons?
Okay, so the first one, right after, you know, you get your feet wet with that beginner stuff, we throw you right into an estimate. So basically just walking you through step by step an estimate, starting with each tab of the program. So the claim info, we enter in all the, you know, the insured stuff, get them real comfortable at filling out all the information correctly.
Right.
Then we are going to perform a sketch, and the reason I do this is you'll understand the program a lot better if you understand how it was built to integrate with Sketch. I know a lot of these guys, they use EagleView, that's great, but even having basic sketch skills can allow you to sketch an interior of a room and get O&P when right. before you might not have the skills to do that. It's pretty important to have just a little bit of sketch skills. So I do go through Sketch and teach the basics here, just starting out, you know, just a basic estimate.
Right.
We're going to do a sketch. Then we go to estimate items, of course, which is the meat potatoes of every estimate. Whenever you're working with Xactimates, where you add all your line items for labor and material. Then I teach, you know, how to print correctly and how to complete. Some of the seasoned guys that have been using Xactimate, like for maybe 5 years, they may not be running the correct report type. You want apples for apples when you're dealing with insurance adjusters, so you want to be running the correct report. I'm going to teach you in this first lesson exactly what you should be doing.
Yeah.
So that's what we go over in the print and complete.
And that's,
then we go over some...
Not to interrupt
I'm sorry,
you.
Go ahead.
Not to interrupt
yeah.
you, but that's the kind of stuff where, like, when people ask us, I swear I've copied this estimate exactly like the insurance company, but it's still a little bit off. Like, what's going on? That's where you can show them, like, here's how to actually make it match. So that's
right.
cool.
Yeah, so, yeah, exactly. There's a lot of little nuanced details. If you just know them, you can fix stuff like that. So, yeah, exactly. Yeah, and then the last thing here, we go through over common Xactimate issues. When you're first learning the program, or even people who use it every day, sometimes windows get closed. You're like, what the heck? Where did that go? So I cover this stuff up front to like alleviate any frustrations you have like going further in the class. We're going to fix those issues pretty, you know, pretty much up front. So, that's...
I lost the search bar for like 3 days one time, and I was like... How in the French toast am I going to, I was like, does anybody know? And I was trying to couldn't find it. Or stuff exactly. like, you know, for example, finding items. Like another thing that, and I would still forget sometimes, you'd look for Ridgevent. And if you looked, I almost said Googled. If you search Ridgevent, it's like zero results. You're like, what? But it's continuous Ridgevent. So showing those little things like that, like so that you just don't get stuck. Is worth its weight in gold, in my opinion. But okay, carry on.
Yeah, so that's actually, it's great that you brought that up. That's one of the lesson topics. It's not in the first lesson, but it is here down further, is different ways of searching. Because when I started writing estimates, I thought that drywall was called sheetrock. Because growing up in a household of a construction, you know, our family, we always called it sheetrock. I didn't know that Xactimate, that that's a brand, and I have to call it drywall. Same thing with like a jacuzzi tub. It's called a jetted tub. So I teach ways to search.
Overhead.
Right.
All those items.
Exactly.
There's a huge list of them.
You have to learn the language of the program, and if you don't know it, how are you going to learn it? So I teach a whole lesson on that, on how to find things. There's different ways of searching, so that if you don't know what it's called, there's ways to get there and find it. So that's one whole lesson in here that I have set up. So thanks for bringing that up. Yeah. The second topic here, I'm going to teach you how to set up your company correctly in Xactimate, even though you may be running it already. I can show you some tips and tricks and shortcut stuff that, you know, will help you get make sure that your company's set up correctly. So,
well, especially when you're like sending in a report, if you're in like a little bit of a heated adjuster battle and you want to send in your packet or like your assessment, you want it to look as polished and professional and put together as humanly possible. And simple things like having the logo or your credentials and a header or whatever like that.
Yes.
It makes a difference because the adjuster gets it and they're like, okay, I'm not dealing with Tom, Dick, and Harry who are sending me a legal pad.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I'm exaggerating, but okay.
No, totally. And you know, that's another thing we cover is I think about probably 10% of contractors use opening statements. That might even be a blown up figure. I mean, it's a tiny percentage of people who use opening statements, and there's a lot of verbiage you can put in an opening statement, and that can help you get O&P paid. It can help you show that you have your general contractor's license. There's a myriad of things that you can do. So that's just one of the topics I cover in that section. That's just one. So there's
seen
a lot
that,
of.
By the way, I like it.
Yeah. So that's that portion there. Next, we're going to go ahead and cover basic roof sketching. Again, there are reasons for you to learn how to get at least the basics of sketch, and so we have a whole section dedicated to that. Then you've got an intermediate estimate here, and you know, the thing with Xactimate, it's repetition. The more I can get you to perform the same actions but yet grow on those same actions, that's what the course is designed to do. So this intermediate estimate, we're going to start branching out into different estimate items like activity codes and changing prices and things like that. So you kind of just build the knowledge base but still repeat the same thing so that you get really comfortable.
And I like that, yeah, and I like that you're showing them real claims, like here's what the house looks like. Here's, you know, because now they can look, it's, it just helps, like I'm very visual. I want to see, show me an example. Yeah. So instead of just being like, here's how you do it. Because when people go to try to do it on their own sometimes, it's like they shit their pants. They're like, So if you have a real example, they can go, okay, and connect the dots. So I like, you've got multiple of those in there.
Not so, and that's what makes it so different than the exact word training, because they're so theoretical. They're like, here, sketch this thing that we're going to give you. It's like, no, what did it actually look like? What did it, I need to see it in my brain, because I work on a 3D roof, right? I don't work, I'm not an architectural drawer.
Right.
You know, I'm out there measuring 3D things. So it's so nice to have, you know, a visual that you can connect it, like you just said, connect the dots.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah, yeah. So the next topic here, I go over a bunch of intermediate estimating concepts. One of the big ones is, how did Xactware come up with the price for that?
Yeah.
And go into detail, explaining their processes. I actually live in Salt Lake City. They're about 30 miles south of me. I've been to their headquarters. I've talked with them about these issues. So I have kind of a insider, you know, insight into what they're doing with their price list and stuff.
Right. Well, and so, mechanics of line items, is that, what's that lesson in there?
The mechanics of line items, basically, if you don't, let's say that you want to detach and reset a pipe jack because State Farm won't pay to remove and replace it. Well, there's still money you can get out of them by detaching and resetting. However, there isn't a detach and reset pipe jack in the program. So learning the mechanics of line items, I teach you how to kind of create your own line item or manipulate it in a way that suits the, you know, what you're trying to do. Like detach and reset a light fixture, yeah, that's easy to find, but there's some other detach and reset items that you might not, there's not a line item for. You need to know how to manipulate it. That's what mechanics learn.
Does that also include, like, helping these guys understand what is and isn't included in a line item? So when an adjuster says something like the notorious, well, that's included in this line item, or that's already included in the price per square. You're showing them,
absolutely.
Here's how to use the actual language in the software, how to find those things in a snap so that you can handle that objection and move on, right?
Absolutely. Yep, right. Exactly. And then there's ways that you can, there's actually on a line item level, the way that you can print exactly what it includes. You can do that in Xactimate. You can actually create a PDF document. Here's what the line item includes. But send it to the insurance company and see.
And then say, you know, boom, roasted.
Draped from Xactimate. How are you telling me masking is included in paint? It's not on the list.
Clearly not. Right. Okay, great. That's good.
Yeah.
All right, moving on.
Let's see. Some other things. I talk about photo resizing. That seems to be a thorn in the side of a lot of storm restoration contractors. Just how do I house all these stupid, huge photos? We go over, it's not in Xactimate, but I give some tips on how to, keep your file size down, and then how to kind of create a system of organization that will help save your life.
And
so we go over that.
Can you import photos into Xactimate for your estimates?
Oh, absolutely. Oh, absolutely. Yeah. And it's great to do that because it makes it all, you know, one nice inclusive package that you send to the insurance company instead of sending like 10 emails and, you know, they're not seeing what you're trying to do. Exactly.
Especially when you're doing a supplement.
Yes.
Because it's like, here's why we need this for this. Like,
here's
we need scaffolding.
Or here's where the nails are nailed through the step flashing. And, you know, I'm not going to take time to re-nail through that. We're going to replace it.
Right.
Come on, guys.
Right. Okay,
yeah,
cool.
Yeah, that's great.
I've done that. I can think of many instances, actually, where the adjuster's like, send me pictures. Actually, I had to write my own claim once. There was a guy who, this was a big claim, huge 3-story house, steep, massive roof. It was going to be a great claim, but I was doing it like in the winter time, I can't remember if it was like November, if it was February or March, but anyways, it was like real sketchy weather. The adjuster has to cancel two separate times to do the meeting because the weather's bad, can't get on the roof. So I was like, do you want me? I'm like, I already have like the Xactimate. I have the pictures. I have, you know, I've got the whole thing, the agreement. would that help? And he's like, send me over everything you have. I might not even have to go out there. So if I could do it all in a adjuster's report style, like I'm already doing the Xactimate, but if I can import all the pictures and everything necessary too, it's all one bundle. It makes it less work for the adjuster. It makes it easier to get approved. So
and then they're happy.
Right.
And then, yeah, it's easy to negotiate because, you know, you did all the work and you helped them out. So, yeah, absolutely. Yep, exactly. And that's, you know, that's a great point about learning Sketch is in that situation, that would greatly benefit you. You could just knock out the sketch and it looks just like he wrote the report.
Exactly.
And he would thank you like, so, oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Because most insurance companies require that the adjuster's sketch. They don't allow, you know, them to go straight out the eagle view. So yeah, just a side note there.
Yep.
That's another reason to learn the sketch. All right.
What are the last two? Annotating images and F9 notes.
So I see a lot of guys in the field that'll pull up paint, like put the picture in paint, draw the little circle, and I'll be like, hail damage, hit this siding here. Xactimate does that inside of Xactimate.
Like so that circles you don't have and to highlight go... stuff?
Yes, and then you can type text on the picture. You can shade things. Like if there's water damage, you can't really see it on the ceiling. They have the shade tool that helps enhance it.
So
you
can... Oh, yeah. Instagram for hail damage and water damage inside Xactimate? So, like, if you have, for example, blinding white siding and you're swearing to the adjuster that there's hail damage on there, but it's kind of hard to see it, you can circle circle on a picture and shade it so that you can see it better.
Yeah, it's really cool.
I wish I was still writing estimates. I would do that all day long. Instagramming it. No filter. Excellent. Okay, onward. Notes.
Next,
F9.
F9 notes and templates, a lot of people, you know what F9 notes are. They're the notes below the line item that you explained what the line item is. Did you know you can save those notes and then use them later instead of typing the same note 100 times?
So like when you have ice and water shield and you're saying, this is necessary because according to the IRC 906.2.7.1, in the jurisdiction of it, you can just save it.
Yep.
Didn't know that either.
And... don't want to give too much away, but you can create a macro with all the note templates in it and just go, shabam, done.
So many bells and whistles. All right, that's awesome.
Yeah. Next up, we just go ahead and run through another estimate. Again, bumping up the difficulty, learning how to add elevations to your grouping tree, interior damage to your grouping tree, all of that. We really bump up the difficulty on this one here. So.
Okay. So more complex of a claim.
Yes, so we just keep going, you know, amping it up each time.
Right.
Yeah. With the advanced estimating concepts, there's a lot of nuances, like I mentioned before, that you need to know to negotiate correctly, but I don't want to just throw them at you first thing because it won't make any sense. So now that we've built this knowledge base, we can go into things like components and supporting events, which are very integral into how what a line item includes. It takes it to the next level on what a line item includes.
Okay.
Basically, yeah. The old base surface charge model is out with 28. Version 27.5 was the last version that they used the base surface charges. What they are doing now is what's called minimum charges, and you need to understand them so that you know they should be added. Don't let State Farm remove those guys. They're there for a reason.
Yeah.
We put them in place. So we talk about what was the old, what is the new, what we should be doing with these changes that they've made.
And what do you think, based on the new model, because I haven't used that, but what's the average minimum charge that gets added?
Oh, it's all different, you know, for each trade. So basically they have, let's say for drywall, you have a 200, well, let's do roofing. We have a $300 roofing labor minimum that no roofer is going to come out for less than $300.
Right, they won't even step out of the truck.
Exactly. So if you throw a shingle, like let's say we're replacing one shingle, right? Xactimate knows because you added a roofing line item that it now needs to pull up this minimum charge.
Right.
So the more roofing items you add to the estimate, it's going to start deducting from the automatic minimum charge.
Okay. Well, even that, like that as an example, I know I always do this, but for a company that does 100 jobs a year, if they can learn how to actually support and get that minimum charge, they're adding $30,000 in revenue with that one item on top of their claim.
And it's great because Xactimate adds it in the background, but you wouldn't know. You wouldn't know where to find that.
Right.
If you weren't
or how to argue it's, it when they yeah, try to peel
exactly.
it off.
Exactly.
Right.
Yes.
Okay.
Exactly.
Yep. Macros. Yep. This is probably my favorite.
Yep. One-stop shop. Every single line item you can think of, build it into a macro, slap it onto every you know, estimate that you're writing and then delete off what you don't need. I do this every day. This is how I write so many estimates a day, is the macros. If I didn't have macros, I don't even know what I would do with myself.
Just shoot yourself right in the head. So for anybody that doesn't understand what this is, because I didn't even know until like this year, I was like, macros? I'm like, you mean like nutrition, like weightlifting? So the macros basically, for any type of roof, if you've got a 30-year architectural roof, you already know that the meat and potatoes is going to be shingles, remove and replace, drip edge, ice water shield, felt, maybe steep or high charge. All these items that are, all, you know, pipe jacks, whatever. These are pretty much almost every single time going to be there. So you can literally click a button and Xactimate's like, boop, here's your estimate. And you just adjust a couple numbers and you can take off if there's, instead of a lead pipe boot, there's a just like neoprene, 3-in-1. Put that one in there. So this literally cuts your estimating time in half. Like when we say that, we're not exaggerating.
Yeah, I've got it down. I mean, really drilled down, it's a quarter of the time than when I first started writing estimates. I mean, I've got my macros built perfectly.
It's like, boom, done.
And so, and I build them per area. So if you have several different companies, you know, or several different offices in several different areas, we just started working in Florida. So they have Renail there. I've never seen that. Renail the decking. 30-pound felt, all these specific Florida. So I have a Florida macro. So I don't forget, because I don't ever, you know, these are new items.
Right.
Just add the Florida one and roll with it. It's amazing.
This, like, for a salesperson, if you can spend less time estimating, you have more time to sell. Or you have more free time if you're happy with the amount that you're selling. You know, like, nothing drains your battery more than sitting in front of the computer, typing, your ass is getting flatter with every passing moment, you're going blind, you know, it's like, it's just, apart from I get a break and I get to be in the air conditioning, it's just like a time suck, you know?
It is. So this is, it can be, but not after you go through my stuff.
That's it's a shameless plug. I love it. All right. And then what's the Alina's preferences?
So my preferences, the way I have them set up, is for time-saving devices. So I don't have to go in there and add my company header every time. It automatically shows up. I don't have to add my opening statement. It auto-populates.
So those default kinds of settings.
Default settings, yes. And some of them pertain to Sketch, and they can save your life. I have some really good ones there, too. So
awesome.
Yeah, just how I have my settings set up, my defaults.
Right. Okay. Carry on.
And then we get to the supplement your estimate. So I teach you how to go ahead and do that. I'm not sure if everybody knows this or not, but I own a supplementing company. So I have best practices that we use in our company. I teach you how we do it. And we average around 20 to 30% on our files, 20 to 30% increase over and above what the original statement of loss paid.
We'll take
so I teach you exactly, I teach you exactly what we use and our formatting and how we do it.
Which goes so seamlessly, like, here's what I love about this whole program is it goes so seamlessly with my training. Like, these guys already have a world of experience with, like, the negotiations, the talking, like, the back and forth, what to say. But your program takes the technical knowledge so that they're fusing the, I get the big picture, I know what to say and do. Now I'm using the software to plug these two together, and it's just like a bulletproof case. You know?
Awesome. Yeah, it's so amazing.
I like it. I like it a lot.
So once we get more comfortable writing supplement estimates, I then take you into my live supplementing where I'm going to go through three actual files and just show you how it's done. Yeah.
Excellent.
Yep. So we have more coming on the board here too. We're going to be, there are more topics that will be included. Advanced sketching is one of them for those who are interested in that, and some other things to come. So this site is meant to just keep growing and building and more information being added all the time, and that's what the membership would give you.
Awesome. Yeah. Well, excellent. I love it. Dude,
good.
Like, business owners would lose a lot less hair and not feel forced to drink so much whiskey if they had this program just to, like, simplify using the software. Like, I'm pretty darn good at using Xactimate, like what most people would say. Well, I know how to use it. but there is still so much stuff that I just have no idea how to do, or just like the little things that shouldn't be that hard, but I just get stuck and I waste like 40 minutes clicking around furiously, like trying to find this one stupid thing. And like Exactware's tech support is absolutely useless. Like, it is a joke. You have to pay literally $20 to call and ask one question.
Yeah, it's insane. Like, literally. And that's one, another part of our membership site is we have a forum where you can go and ask your questions, kind of like a mini tech support, but get actual people, you know, to help you. Yeah. So in that same vein, the actual Xactimate training classes as well that Xactware offers, they're not only expensive, but they cover irrelevant information that you would never use. I mean, it's just nuts.
Right.
So, you know, with this course, we specialize in everything a storm restoration contractor would need in order to learn the program, use it on a daily basis. And so none of that money goes to waste that, you know, you would pay Xactware. When you only use, like, you know, this much, they're teaching you things that you'll never use.
Right.
So
stuff about car losses or carpet and, like,
it's nuts.
It's stuff that you just never need. Exactly. Yeah, like your program is 100% focused on only what's relevant to the storm restoration contractor. Like, I've said this before, I'll say it again. Everything they need, nothing they don't. It's great. I know a lot of people are excited to get it. We keep getting emails. People are like, is this done yet? So thank you for building it. And that's pretty much it. So guys, essentially, like, you're getting a comprehensive online course to easily train either yourself or your staff how to utilize and master Xactimate to its full potential, so you're not just having the software and it's sitting there just writing estimates when it can do so much more. And guys, it's going to teach you how to sketch, teach you how to do the macros, you know, keys to overcoming adjusters' objections to line items by using Xactimate to do so, and then advanced estimating, saving you time, literally cutting that time in front of the computer in half, giving you more time to sell, eliminating missed opportunities, and ultimately just maximizing your scopes with the software. So it's awesome. That's pretty much it. Cool. Well, guys, how can, Alina, how can they get a hold of you if they want to ask questions or whatever about the program?
Yeah, so email me at my training address here. It's alina@virtuetraining.com. And my first name, A-L-E-N-A, and then at virtue, V-I-R-T-U, so no E. So alina@virtuetraining.com. Be happy to explain the program in depth and answer any questions anyone might have.
Cool. Well, that's it then. Adios. All Thank you for taking time to show us everything, the ins and outs. And guys, we're excited for you guys to start using it. So cool. Add it to your arsenal. Good.